Hi, welcome to the third part of our Web Mapping Basics series. In this episode, we explain how to convert between the different coordinate systems you need for web maps. I'm Tom from MapTiler. We're here to help you build great maps. Let's start with geographical coordinates. Longitude specifies the west to east, so left to right, position of a point on the Earth's surface. It's measured in degrees as an angle from the centre of the planet. Latitude specifies the south to north position of a point on the Earth's surface, and represents a similar measurement in a vertical axis. Longitude and latitude coordinates are used by GPS devices and the World Geodetic System, WGS84. More about that later. Points with the same longitude create a line called a meridian. The origin of the grid, with a longitude equal to zero, is called the prime meridian. Normally, this is the one that runs through Greenwich in London. Points with the same latitude create a circle called a parallel. The parallel at 0 degrees latitude is called the equator. The lines of longitude and latitude create a grid that is 360 by 180 degrees. If you draw them directly on a screen, you get a map with the aspect ratio of 2 to 1. If the grid has the origin in the middle, we can call it the Global Geodetic System. Note, longitude is often represented by lambda, and latitude by phi. We often refer to the Global Geodetic System by the EPSG code 4326, but more about this in the map projection episode. However, maps like these can also be called unprojected. The problem with unprojected maps is that once you zoom in, features like buildings and islands are going to be greatly deformed, stretched out horizontally. As you can see in this map of New York, Manhattan Island appears much wider than we're used to seeing it in other maps. Once you project the map, the buildings, islands, and all the other features appear in the shapes we're used to seeing. Again, we'll talk more about this in the map projections video. Web maps are usually in the Mercator projection. This uses meters as its units, and the planet is shown as a square. Note, this is the projection often used for raster tiles in web maps and GIS map services. The square is divided up using X and Y axes, and coordinates are given in meters with a range of around minus 20 to plus 20 million. Why do we have around 20 million meters in each axis? Well, the equator is just over 40 million meters long, which is the circumference of the Earth. Each axis is half this value in length, creating a grid that stretches from pole to pole and right around the globe. So how can we convert latitude and longitude to meters? We know that the maximum values in latitude and longitude are 180 and 90, and we know that there are around about 20 million meters, so we can use the functions shown here to convert from one system to the other. These functions are available from maptiler.com/tiles in a range of different programming languages. Computer screens have coordinates in pixels, and the Mercator projection has coordinates in meters. If you want to show a map on a computer screen, you have to convert meters to screen coordinates in pixels. And this conversion varies depending on the zoom level. As we saw in the video about zoom levels, each one has a different number of pixels representing the whole Earth. The top level, zoom 0, usually has 256 by 256 pixels. The next level, 512 by 512, and so on. If we look at zoom level 0, the origin of the grid for screen coordinates is in the top left corner, and the maximum coordinates can be found in the bottom right corner. Zoom level 1 has double the tiles, so the maximum coordinates are double those of zoom level 0. And this pattern repeats for all the following zoom levels as well. Here you can see how to recalculate pixels to meters. Basically, you need to know the resolution calculated from the radius of the Earth, the tile size, and the zoom level. Once you have the resolution, Then you can multiply this by the pixel values and subtract half the circumference of the Earth to get the pixel values in meters. In the video about zoom levels, we talked about why we need tiles and how to address them. Each tile has three coordinates, x, y, and z. Z is the zoom level, for example, zoom 2, and x and y give us the position of the tile in this zoom level. Usually, x and y are counted from the top left corner. This system is used by MapTiler, OpenStreetMap, and is the OGC Web Map Tile Service standard. However, in some cases, x and y can be counted from the bottom left corner. This is used, for example, by the Tile Map Service, or TMS. To get the tile size from pixels, we just need to use the floor division of pixels by tile size. So here's the really good news. You don't need to rewrite any of these functions. We've provided them all for you in Python, JavaScript, C#, PHP, and Java. Just go to maptiler.com/tiles and take what you need. I hope you found this video helpful. Please click like and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss the next one. Bye for now.